Need for Speed Payback, Free Roam, Multiplayer is coming. It's official, it's true, it's damn true. News flash, douchebags. Yeah, 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 yeah. So basically, I'm sitting there eating a box of barbecue wings, enjoying my New Year's Day, when my phone started popping off. I thought, you know what? I don't want to do any work today. I don't want to do anything YouTube-based. I just want to enjoy my barbecue chicken and my beer on New Year's Day. Picked up my phone a few hours later and realized what an idiot I was, because it was a tweet from none other than the official Need for Speed Twitter account pushing out the fact that they are going to be giving us what we've been asking for, what we've been crying for, what we've been complaining about. A missing component that should have been there from day one. The free roam multiplayer, the ability to go into the open world with 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, who knows, however many of your mates, and just absolutely prat about for however long you want. That mode is coming to Need for Speed Payback. It's coming at some point in 2018. No official word on the official date as yet, but as this is an official tweet, which has also been posted on their Facebook channel and in Reddit forums, we can definitely take this as gospel. And I don't know about you guys, I'm really, really happy. Well, I say I'm really happy. I am happy to a degree, okay? You know, I'm happy at the fact that you guys are going to have the opportunity to do exactly what I said at the beginning, which is prat around with your mates and get into all sorts of shenanigans in the open world. I'm happy that Ghost have actually finally implemented one of the huge missing pieces that I spoke about in one of my previous videos when I explained how I feel the game was released unfinished. What I'm still slightly unhappy about is the fact that I don't know how much this is going to do to repair some of the damage that has been caused by not having this element in the game previously. Now, obviously, it's going to put a lot of smiles on a lot of faces, but there's obviously going to be people who go off of initial impression. There are going to be people who have already made their mind up, who are not tuned into the actual virtual racing community enough to understand when improvements are made to games, when patches are made. So part of me is a little bit upset, because I feel that those people who may have shunned the game for that very reason, who may not know about this news, probably won't get a chance to experience. And I guess that's part of the reason as to why I feel it's really important as media within YouTube that we put these bits of information out as much as possible. What this also means is that Ghost have now gone and systematically ruined my 2017 end of year review. If you watched that video, if you haven't, I'm going to put the link in the description box, and it's also going to pop up at the end of this video. But basically, I went through various different racing games on the channel that I've played throughout 2017, and I basically gave them their negative points and their positive points. And for Payback, one of the negative points I put in was the fact there was no free roaming multiplayer, which is something they've already fixed. So thank you, Ghost, if you're watching. Thank you for making my video look absolutely useless. It's not useless, to be quite honest. There's still plenty of information there which will be of use to some of you guys. But if you're a fan of 2K, if you're a fan of drifting, if you're a fan of getting your car sideways with your buddies, with your pals, with your chums, you can do it. If you're a fan of playing hide and seek, guess what? You can do it. If you're a fan of taking in-game photography and you want to get you and your car crew with all the different wraps, or whether it be the same wrap altogether, you can do it. Members of the douchebag squad, we can now post for group pictures, group photos. It's now possible, and it will all be facilitated. It will all be made possible with the much loved Free Roam multiplayer update. Now, thus far, there isn't any other information in relation to what this update will consist of. I expect there'll be some bug fixes included as well. But what I can say is that this will not cost you a single thing. You heard? Hello, I'm talking to you, mate, Mr. Cynical. This will cost nothing. It's going to be a free update. You will not pay a penny to experience your online free roam multiplayer experience in Need for Speed Payback. I'm not really celebrating that, because you shouldn't be paying anyway, but obviously it's just to completely dead any argument that there is any cost involved. There isn't. So guys, as I said, I wasn't planning on putting this video out today. It caught me completely blindsided, and for that reason, it's going to be short, it's going to be snappy. As always, I'm massively interested in knowing what your thoughts are on this. Drop them in the comments. If you haven't bought Need for Speed Payback and this was one of the reasons as to why you hadn't bought it, are you now going to be buying it? If you've had the game from launch and now it's been getting a little bit dry, a little bit boring, a little bit stale, is this going to be something that's going to rejuvenate the game for you? Is it going to bring it back to life? Is it going to extend your playtime? Either way, good or bad, let me know. Drop your thoughts in the comments. Now, before I go, very, very, very important. Yesterday was the end of 2017. But more importantly, if you're a car lover, it also marked the end of production for one of the most iconic, one of the most charismatic, and one of the most brutal cars ever to come out of America. I'm talking about the Dodge Viper. And yesterday, it was only a few hours ago, I put out a tribute video just paying my respects to a car that managed to slide its way into my heart. Once you've watched this video, if you can kindly just go and pay your respects by watching that video. It's very short, it's only about 6 or 7 minutes. And then just drop your thoughts below in the comments section as to what the Dodge Viper meant to you. Again, I'll leave the link in the description box and you will see it pop up at the end of the video. So yeah, that's pretty much it. If it's your first time around here, I wish you a born welcome. Hit the like button, hit the subscribe button, swing the damn hell out of the notification bell, and I will see you when the next video comes out. Take it easy. Peace.